We are in your presence again to thank you for the blessing of all of from Monday till now. We thank you for your provision, your protection, and the fact that you preserve us all this time. We thank you for a new month. We thank you for everything that you have done, the ones we know, the one we do not know. We thank you for the lives of our family. We thank you for the life of the church. We thank you also, Father, for bringing us together every day to worship you. We glorify your name and exalt you for who you are. You are the main reason why we're still alive. People are out there that are being fed and being taken care of. That is not our portion. And for that, we glorify you and thank you. We thank you for the love of for the lives of our family. Our children go out there, they're shooting and stabbing and all events that happen. This is not our children's portion. We glorify you for that. We thank you, for Jehovah, for the rest of this month, that you would make our life worthy. You will make everything that we do. Your hands will be in everything that we do. And we'll have the cause to glorify your name at the end of the month and at the beginning of next month in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen, amen. Good morning once again and welcome to Morning Devotion platform and program. The Bible says we shall enter God's court with praise. So let us all lift up our voices and as we sing praises to God through our time of worship.
Great and mighty God,
I more time, sing with us. Say, at the center.
At the center of it all.
Yeah.
You that I see.
Jesus.
You that I see.
Nobody else is worthy. At the center of
it. At the center of it all.
Only you. His hands wherever you are, declare it. There is power.
There is power in your name.
Yeah, miracles happen.
Miracles happen
in your name. As we lift the voices,
as we lift the voice of praise,
it's you. Bigger than the biggest. You were strong, stronger than the strongest. You were high, higher than the highest. You were greater, greater than the greatest.
You were bigger, bigger than the biggest. You were stronger than the strongest.
Amen, amen. We thank God for that amazing time of worship. He's so truly worthy to be worshipped always. Amen. We shall now go into our general prayers this morning. And this morning for our general prayers, we will be praying for personal dedication. We'll be praying for personal dedication. So pray for your personal dedication. Amen, amen. And then the first prayer says, Father, thank you for today, the day you have made. I receive the gift of today, and I thank you for it. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for the gift of the days. We thank you, we truly thank you for the blessing of a new day. We are so grateful for your love for us, the day that you yourself have made, and I receive the gift of today, and I'm so grateful and I thank you for it. Your word in Psalm 118 says, this is the day which the Lord hath made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, Heavenly Father, we don't take any day that we get on this earth for granted, because no day is promised. Tomorrow is not promised. And so I really appreciate the gift of today, the blessings of a new day. And I really, really, really appreciate it. And I thank you. Thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now, prayer number two. Father, Let every barrier on my path of celebrations this month, August 2023, be crushed and destroyed by the power of the Holy Spirit. Oh, let us pray. Oh, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus this morning, I declare and I dedicate today that any and every barrier on my path of celebrations this month, this month of August 2023, that any barrier be crushed and destroyed by the power of the Holy Spirit in Jesus' mighty name. The word in Isaiah says, that said the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden, to subdue nations before him, and I'll loose the loins of kings, to open before him the two-leaved gates, and the gates shall not be shut. I will go before thee and make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron. O Father, by the powerful name of Jesus, I declare that every barrier on my path of celebration this month is crushed and destroyed by the power of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, I've prayed. Amen. Our prayer number three, dedication number three. Father, in Jesus' name, baptize me with the spirit of dedication, resulting in undeniable order of kingdom commitment and service in my life. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, by the powerful name of Jesus Christ, baptize me with the spirit of dedication, resulting in undeniable order of kingdom commitments and service in my life. In Jesus' mighty name. The word in John chapter 12 says, if any man serve me, let him follow me. And where I am, there shall also my servant be. If any man serve me, him will my Father honor. Oh, Heavenly Father, oh, this morning I declare that in Jesus' mighty name, Lord, baptize me with the spirit of dedication, resulting in undeniable order of kingdom commitments. And let me be of service all my life to your kingdom. In Jesus' mighty name, I've prayed. Amen. And prayer number four. Father God, I am asking that you specially baptize me with passion for souls, making me a kingdom-minded, fruitful harvester of souls in my walk with you in this land. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, almighty, ever-living God, I'm asking you this morning that you specially baptize me with a passion for souls. Make me a kingdom-minded, fruitful harvester of souls in my walk with you in this land, always and every day, in Jesus' mighty name. The word in Proverbs 11 says, the fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth souls is wise. Again, in Daniel 12, it says, and they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever. Oh, Heavenly Father, this morning I'm asking you that you specially baptize me with passion for souls. Make me a kingdom-minded, fruitful. Make me a kingdom-minded, fruitful harvest of souls in my walk with you in this land, in Jesus' mighty name. Pray, amen. Now, prayer number five. Father, by the power of the Holy Ghost, grant me supernatural utterance that will break the heart of every unsaved soul unto repentance as I minister to them. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, by the mighty power of the Holy Ghost, grant me supernatural utterance that will break the heart of every unsaved soul unto repentance as I minister to them in Jesus' mighty name. Your word in Acts chapter 2 says, now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remissions of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Oh, Heavenly Father, by the mighty power of the Holy Ghost, grant me that supernatural utterance that will prick the heart of every unsaved soul into repentance as I minister to them in Jesus' mighty name. We have prayed, amen. Now, prayer number six. Father, empower me with the spirit of love so I can continue to love your word, making it become my way of life. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, our Lord and Master, this morning I come before you and I ask for empowerment. Empower me with the spirit of love so that I can continue to love your word, making it become my way of life every day and all day in Jesus' mighty name. Your word in Psalm 119 says, oh, how love I thy law. It is my meditation all day. Thou through thy commandments has made me wiser than mine enemies. For they are ever with me. I have more understanding than all my teachers. For thy testimonies are my meditation. I understand more than the ancients because I keep thy precepts. Oh, Father, I pray for empowerment of your spirit of love so that I can continue to love your word, making it become my way of life, that I can grow, I will grow in wisdom day in and day out because of my love for your word in Jesus' mighty name. Pray, amen. Now, finally, our prayer number seven. Father, anoint me afresh with the oil of gladness so I can make the most of my kingdom advancement and endeavors with unearning rewards. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, our Lord and my Lord and Master, Father, this morning I ask for your anointing, your fresh anointing with oil of gladness on me so that I can make the most of my kingdom advancements, endeavors with unearned rewards in Jesus' mighty name. Your word in Habakkuk 3 says, although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall fruits be in the vines, the labor of the olive shall fail, and the fields shall yield no meat, the flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will have joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength, and he will make my feet like hinds' feet, and he will make me to walk upon mine high places, to the chief singer of my strength instrument. Oh, Father, anoint me afresh this morning with the oil of gladness so that I can make the most of my kingdom advancements and endeavors with unending rewards. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed this morning. Amen, amen, amen. We thank God for answers to our general prayers this morning. It is now time to go into our Bible reading this morning. And this morning, our Bible reading will be taken from Psalm chapter 100, verses 1 to 5. Psalm 100, verses 1 to 5. And our Bible reading this morning will be read by Sister Claire. Let us receive and welcome her.
Good morning, family. This is Psalm 100, 1 to 5. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. The word of God for the people of God.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for reading the word for us this morning, Sister Claire. We shall now receive our charge for this morning. And as it has been all week, our charge today will be brought to us by our senior pastor, Tunji. Let us receive and welcome him. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. We thank God again this morning. What a great day again before the Lord. Remember, we are still on the purpose of worship. I wouldn't go through the previous things we've said today so that I can round it up. But yesterday, we stopped around Malachi 1, verse 13, where he says, and you say, what a burden. And you sniff at it contemptuously. Praise the Lord Almighty. What a burden. Remember, all these things, well, I may even say it physically anyway, is the saying of your heart, displaced by your feelings. He says, when you bring injured, crippled, diseased animals and offer them as sacrifices, should I accept them from your hands? Like I said, the moment you start hearing that, that feeling uncomfortable, that's your heart speaking. What a burden. I say, what an insult to God. Who gave you life, who sustained you, who brought you to where you are. That's why he said in Deuteronomy, when you get there and you are satisfied and you are taken care of, do not forget the Lord your God. Do not forget the Lord your God. Don't mean just be thanking him back with words. No. What he meant is from what he has blessed you with, because you know the way the system is set up by God, you return regularly, consistently, fervently. With your offerings in worship. I said the source, which is God himself, is more important than the resources. And we should never preoccupy ourselves with the resources at the expense of the source. Look at it. If you pick a yardstick from Job, all your miles for years were wiped up at an instant. Your resources will not be wiped up. I'm just giving you a sense of that. We must consistently and constantly and consistently wrap together, acknowledge the soul, celebrate the soul. That's the heart of what we're talking about. Worship is not supposed to be something you struggle with. Rearing offering to God in worship is not supposed to be something you struggle to do. It should be your delight. But it becomes a problem when we don't really connect the source to the resources we have. That's why you say, then you shall say in your heart that my hand and my strength has gotten me this wealth. You have disconnected from the source. Attributing, getting it all to yourself. Worshiping him, offering to him, which is a major part of worship, should be your delight. It should flow naturally. A man of God said, you don't have to depend on a praise team to get you into his presence. Thank God for praise teams. Don't misunderstand it. But you don't have to depend on that. And the reason we do that is because we don't have our own songs in us. We don't have our own praise of him in us. I saw something from scripture and I said, wow. When reading this scripture, Isaiah 30, verse 29, for a long time, I can quote it ahead. But then I saw, it says, and ye shall have a song. Wow. If it stops there, it would be a bit confusing, but like I always tell you, the Bible will always qualify what it says. beautifully. Watch. And you, Isaiah 30, verse 39, and ye shall have a song as in the night when a holy plenty is kept and gladness of heart. That is, you know, when they have these holy gatherings in the night, they sing with gladness of heart. That's what he said. You shall have a song and gladness of heart. What? He now qualifies this also. You have that song as when one goeth with a pipe to come into the mountain of the Lord, to the mighty one of Israel. Not that he's in the presence of the Lord. They are always excited and singing, going into his presence, going to his mountain. Not let's say the mountain, put it like the church, for example, the facility. They are always singing individually, excited, going there. You shall have a song. So they don't even arrive there waiting for somebody to motivate them. And then I pick it up to the New Testament, where Paul the Apostle chose one of the core scriptures we've used for this believers meeting. He said, how is it, dear brethren, when you come together, every one of you hath a song. When you call, you have. Every one of you. When you come, you have. Every one of you had a psalm, had a doctrine, had a tongue. You don't come empty. You have something in you, something bubbling in you, told the Lord before you even arrive. That is generating songs of appreciation and worship. Even before, watch me, the meeting starts. It's in your coming itself. If you come with a worship or praise already on your tongue, then you are a passenger. You shall have a song as when one goeth up. Everyone who goes to the mountain of the Lord or to the presence of the Lord goes with a song and gladness of heart. Have you not read before? I was glad when they said, let us go to the house of the Lord. That's Psalm 122. My feet shall stand again within thy gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is a city that is built and compact together. I was glad. Why? Because you recognize the thought of all that you see in your life. And you are excited going before him. We just read this morning. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, or you won't enter. And then his court, you see the sequence, with praise. You have not even arrived inside. You enter with. Of course, we have taken that to mean after we have already gathered and then we are doing something, then we now start praising him. No, he said, in case somebody has a fence compound, you are outside, you enter into it with thanksgiving. Now you enter the gate, you are now in the courts to be able to approach unto him is with praise. With songs and gladness of heart. So be thankful unto him and bless his name. Why so much difficulty in lifting up hands, lost in his presence, even as we worship God, as some are just looking around or do some other things? We have to be motivated. Lift up hands now. Praise the Lord, shout to him, pushing you. If you are flowing in that before you come with deep sense of appreciation to him, you will need any motivation. I've been already before, Psalm 34, Proverbs 1. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Because that's what I say every time. Oh, come, everybody, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Because you are one full of praise and worship every time. It's because you are connected, or perhaps you have connected the source with the resources. You're connected, you know. And the only way we do that is with the consciousness that everything I have, everything I will ever have, not just is from him also. You walk in that consciousness. Your heart is established with that. Praise will naturally flow from you. Praise, worship, should be a natural result of the awareness of the source that is God himself. Natural result. Most times, God blesses us with some things. We just thank him for that, and that is all. It has to be continuous. Even as you enjoy them. You think your money bought them. Your money didn't buy anything. God sustained you for them. Paul said, when ye come together, each one comes with a hymn, with a song, with a spiritual song, with a heart full of praise. David puts it this way, don't forget his benefits. As you are enjoying it, you are thanking him for it. Your heart is just, oh God, thank you. When we acknowledge him as the source, worship begins. That's actually where worship begins. Acknowledging him, acknowledging the source is the beginning of worship. Worship begins with acknowledgement. Acknowledgement goes on to celebration. Celebration takes you again into the heart of worship. So when David wrote those psalms and some of the other songs we see in scriptures, they were not written for entertainment. No. Those songs themselves came out of one's experience or experiences with God. And in so doing, celebrating the credibility of the source. You have a lot of experiences that God has taken you through. But you never turn them to songs of worship. That's why I say you cannot worship beyond what you know about God. Those were their words. Those were their songs. Oh, but it's in the Bible for all of us. Yes, but it's still their song. And I said something yesterday. Until it becomes your tongue, is not worship. And I said, oh, Pastor, you mean I have to write mine? No, that's not what I'm saying. Because those tongues, those hymns, those psalms till today were born out of someone's experience and is returning it back to his God or our God. Now you are just singing it. Oh, Pastor, what are you saying? Are we not to sing it? No, that's not what I said. You can't invent things about God. What I'm saying is, you have to make those songs your songs, based on from your own experience also, because we all have different experiences, but baseline satisfies in most cases. We're singing about the deliverance of God. Have you seen his deliverance? I'm sure you have. But then that song is written about it, but you now connect it with your own experience, bubbling from your inside. It becomes your song. You can sing a song that someone else wrote really in worship. Oh, Pastor, what are you saying? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm not saying you can't sing the song in singing it, but you have to connect with it. And I, like I said yesterday, that's why some songs are so real to you, you didn't write them. But then as you are singing them, that's your experience, and your heart is bubbling. Sometimes you are weeping, the tears just overwhelm you, because that's you. That's because it has become your song. What makes it worth it? You can sing it for entertainment's sake. You can sing it for singing's sake, but there's no connection. That's not worship. And you see someone beside you, the same song. You are enjoying the song, the rhythm, yes, but somebody is lost in it, because that person's experience is also in it. And it flows out. You have to make it your song. Singing someone's testimony. But your testimony must be in it to be worshiped. Look at one of the most beautiful songs ever written. I believe we all know it. It is well with my soul. It is well when peace like a river. We know that song. Powerful. But you know, it's actually born from the heart of someone with his experience. We are not writing songs today. You don't have to be a songwriter to write songs. We told you that. When you are in his presence, overwhelmed with your encounters with him, the words flow. So a lot of us know the story of that man. Lost family, lost everything. And then the word came, it is well with my soul. The other one people have called the most popular gospel song ever written, Amazing Grace, by John Newton. It was born out of his experience of the things he saw in the slave trade that he chose to remove himself from. The reality of redemption and the deliverance of God and the grace of God separating us from the afflictions of this world was wound up in him. And the world is still singing it today. We are not entertainers. No Christian song is for entertainment. Don't misunderstand. We have a lot of entertainment in that area going on these days. No problem. But that's not worship. Where are your experiences of his grace? Those are the things. Because they are already deep-seated in your heart that you connect with in worship. And go to him with words, where your experiences of his goodness, of divine provision, of deliverance, of healing. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not his benefits, who heals all my diseases, who satisfies my mouth with good things, that my strength is renewed as the eagle. Is that your experience? When it becomes your experience and you say those things, they become your words and very powerful. Take them back to him in worship. That's what makes it worship. We sing a lot of songs. I do. Powerful ones written by people. But then the way they make meaning to us is because you are in those songs. If you know what I mean. Your heart is in it. Your experiences are in it. Your encounters with God are in it. Then they become your song. Remember, the value of your God is determined by the knowledge of Him. And you cannot worship beyond that. Never you forget His benefits. And through them, we worship Him. God demands worship. I've talked too much today. I'd like us to go before the Lord. Look at those experiences of your life. Who are you? Where are you from? Where have you been? Where are you now? What has He done? How did He deliver you? Bring those experiences with words to worship the King of Kings today. Just worship Him from your heart, filled with gratitude and appreciation. That's worship. We'll be back together soon. Hallelujah.
Amen. We thank God so much for this amazing time that we have had today. We also thank God for the teachings that we have received and just how to come before the Lord. Psalm 95 says, oh, come, let us sing. It says, I'm sorry. Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving. I'm sorry, can you hear me?
Right.
Okay. It says in verse 2, let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and make a joyful noise unto him. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. That is our whole duty, to worship him, to praise him. But we have learned this week on how to come before him, how to approach our God, the attitude of mind and the words that we bring to God, just singing to him and praising him. And so we thank God so much for this lesson. And while Pastor was preaching, I was just thinking about a list of things even between yesterday and today that God has already done for me, that I just need to sing joyfully to him concerning, that I need to come before him just thanking him for those things and not always just coming to him with my list of to-do things, because he's not our servant. We serve him, not the other way. So today I'm learning to do that and practicing it, just to make a list and come before God and say, God, I want to thank you for these things that you have done, and a lot of things that we don't know about. So we thank God for that. We know that this program runs Monday through Friday. We thank God for a wonderful new month of August. Do not forget to invite people. Just send clips to people and see what they see. You know, let them experience and send them a taste. And when they see what we're experiencing, they will want to come and join us and be a part of the morning devotion program. And that is also our duty to God to do that. We also thank God for the weekend. As you go to your fellowships and your churches, just remember, share the word of God, reach out to others. I want to give you a blessing from that psalm that we prayed today. For the Lord our God is a great God and a great King above all gods. So God, today I bless your people with the knowledge of you, with the understanding of who you are to each one of us, that you're not just our Father that provides our needs, that you are a great God and a great King above all gods. And that as we go today in this knowledge, recognize God in everything you do, so that you know, whatever the situation, he is a great God and a great King above all gods. So whatever is going on in your life, that's who he is. And we thank God for that. So now let us share the goodness. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever. Amen.
God bless you. See you next week. Jesus.